Welcome to this quick demo of JXL. JXL is an app for Jira that combines the power of Jira with the simplicity of spreadsheets. But it's also much more than just the missing better table view in Jira. It fills a lot of feature gaps that Jira traditionally has, and I'm going to walk you through a bunch of these. It's available for Jira Cloud, Data Center, and Server, and in Cloud works with team managed and company managed projects. Now, once installed, there's a Sheets item in your sidebar or in your project navigation. This is a sheet. It has a title, it has some metadata. For example, you can optionally add a description for the audience, to some instructions how to work with it or how it fits into your business processes, that sort of thing. It has, you can switch between sheets up here in the sheet picker. You can organize them in folders. You can star them so the ones relevant to you personally are accessible. And yeah, so they're organized with located in projects, but they can, as you will now see, hold issues of different projects, as many as you like, in fact. Again, this is the title, and I'm editing this sheet now, and this is the sheet scope. So you can either point it to an existing safe filter in Jira, or type a JQL statement. And for users who are a bit intimidated by JQL or less tech savvy in that sense, that's also not a problem because there's our smart composer bar with helpful hints and it works really well. This is the result, obviously. There's issues as displayed as rows and fields as columns, but not only fields, like all sorts of issue related data can be added as columns to your tables. This is how you do that. You add a column like this, and all system standard and all custom fields are supported. You have third-party fields supported from popular third-party apps. We have smart columns, which are sort of calculated values. We have history columns where you can do stuff like, you know, time since status or time in status, time between statuses, time with assignee, and so on. And they're merged columns, which, yeah, they merge fields from team-managed projects and company-managed projects of the same name and type, so that you have one column across that works across issues from different projects. Yeah, so that's it. You can move things around here. You can obviously remove and add columns. What you see is what you get. It's a very intuitive editing experience. I'm going to cancel this now because this sheet was great for what I have in mind here. And now I'm going to show you how to work in Sheets. So you just inline edit away. So let's just put something here. So this is done now. This has changed now. This has changed this is validated and in real time saved to the issue. But it's nonsensical. So I'm just going to say Command Z, or on Windows and Linux systems, Z obviously. And this is undone. So you can redo and undo things in steps. And copy and paste and so on. So if I, well, quickly let's look at other menus. You will see different field types will have different menu editing experiences. Here's a color swatch picker, people picker, here's an asset picker, and so on. There's a date field and so on. So if back to copy and pasting, and this is often a jaw dropper because people don't realize that this works, but it does, and it works just like in Excel or Smartsheet or Airtable or Google Sheets or whatever it is you're using currently in tandem with Jira to manage your issues. So let's say, you know, these guys should all be highest priority, right? So I say Command C, mark the other ones, and say Command V. And now they're changed, they're updated. This works in very intricate patterns. Whatever you feel like doing, you can copy and paste and interchange this data between Jira and other applications that you might be using. You can also say, like, I wanted this here, you know, that sort of thing. This is a transition, obviously, and all that works as you would expect it for a spreadsheet. In addition to that, you can create issues like this. Pick the issue type, pick the project, summary, and then you can open the full dialog to give more details or just create it like that. In addition to that, let's sort and filter stuff. Let's sort by priority, descending, ascending, descending, and clear. So this works as expected. You can also sort by multiple fields simply by using an order by clause in your JQL statement of your sheet scope. Now let's filter stuff. This is an option filter, what we call an option filter. This is a text filter. There's obviously date filters, so this gets really powerful. There's always empty and non-empty options, or you can also filtering happen here in relation to the current day. So a bunch of things like is in past, future. Let's stick with is in specific time period. So let's say, you know, it's any time in the past and up to 7 days in the future, right? And that's what happens now. There's a lot of overdue tasks. So I'm gonna clear this now. I can do this here, but also you can always see your features and down here, clear filter. And there's a bunch of more things you can do. You can hide a column, so then it's completely gone. That's helpful if you want to store different views in the same sheet. I'll get to that in a sec. You can redact them, so this is helpful for if you quickly want to present something to an audience that might not be sort of cleared for certain columns. And you can rename fields. You can give them the header a color. You can make them read only. I'll get to sum ups in a bit. So you can create a table here that is exactly your needs, whatever it is you're trying to do with your issues. So that's a bit of an overview of the table. Let's see what these subtle but extremely powerful features do. Let's start with a sum up. So I just added a sum up, and the entire table is now wrapped in this sum up row. And you can see there's different types of sum ups. There's like progress bars and all sorts of different things. And you can change what sort of sum up you would like to have for each column. Could be none, could be a count for number fields. Number fields also have the obvious stuff like some average, min, max, or a percentile that's configurable, all sorts of things. And there are status bars like status done distribution bar, or let's say status distribution bar percentages. Change this now and you'll see that it's now changed to do in progress done percentages. Now you can, we'll add grouping now. And that will result in let's group by, what are we going to group by? Let's make it simple by assignee. And I'm going to quickly actually collapse this here. Just whenever there's like indentation happening, you can collapse everything here. So there's a bunch of assignees. Let's look into my issues here. So now obviously the sum ups are rolling up across the levels of the table. So I have, let's say, 0.78, and overall they're 276. You can also, by the way, sum this sort of thing up very quickly in by just selecting, marking the cells, and then you have in a status bar down here, you have useful sum ups. So that's sum ups, that's groupings. You can also group by multiple fields or columns and cascade that. I'll show you that in a bit. Switch to hierarchy. So now we see let's collapse this again. We see that we have the sort of default out of the box Jira standard edition issue type hierarchy, which is epics, base issue types, and subtask issue types. That's for a lot of organizations, but also small teams. In fact, not necessarily sufficient. So you need your own issue structure. And that's what we offer here. Those are structures. That's where we combine everything I just talked about. So sum ups, groupings, and hierarchy. So those are all stored structures that I can switch between. I have created them myself. So let's edit one so you see how they look like. So there are levels here. A structure has a title, of course. There are levels here, and a level can at this point be either a hierarchy level, grouping, sum up, or grouping with a sum up. A hierarchy level is where you pick first, you pick an issue type or multiple, or like here, wildcards for an entire issue type level. And then you define how this hierarchy level, the issues on this level are relating to their parent. So either that's by the parent or parent link or epic link field, the default fields in Jira, or it can be issue link descriptions from issue linking. So you can create them yourself in Jira, obviously, and you can use things like is child off and make completely custom hierarchy happen that way. Here in between, there's a project grouping with the sum up. So I have a pretty popular sort of use case here, which is objective, program, initiative, epic or theme or something, and then the actual stories or tasks or and subtasks. Now let's switch this on like this, and you will see this is already much deeper. The indentation here and the collapse expand functionality is much deeper now, and you can also see tree lines here, which you can optionally switch on and off. To make this a bit more easy to understand, I'll just collapse everything. You see now here is my OKR level. Let's actually widen this a little bit. So you see those are objective issue types. In my sheet scope, I pulled them in from a different project, from the OKR project. And then if I open this, in there I have my programs. Excuse me. And then in there I have my initiatives. And then in there I have that grouping by project with a handy sum up that rolls up. So this is obviously a reporting use case. You can use this for anything and everything, really. The use cases are practically endless, but this is sort of a program management planning and tracking sort of use case. And you can go all the way in there down to some, let's say, some team's scope. And yeah, that's what you can do with issue structure. Now let's switch over to ranking. If I switch on ranking, you might know that Jira can configure multiple rank, global rank fields in Jira. If you have them, you can switch between them. Otherwise, this is just going to switch on straight away. I'm going to pick this rank field now. And now the issues here are sorted. Like, I can't do sorting anymore. This is overwritten now by essentially an order by rank statement. And you'll see here I have now these grip lines on the handles of the rows. I can just take this now and move it. Or I can take multiple and move them. And what happens under the hood then is obviously that the rank field is updated accordingly. So that's ranking. Last bigger thing of these advanced features I would like to show is conditional formatting. Now, you can create, just like with the structures, you can create a bunch of them, give them a title and store them here. Let's look into one of them. This is a simple one, yeah, issue type. Hierarchy sort of, or not necessarily hierarchy, issue type is highlighted in different colors. Epics are purple, stories are green, bugs are red. If I switch this on now, you see the table immediately becomes quite colorful. Looks a bit weird like this. If I switch on a bunch of other things, the use cases become clear. You can also say, you know, unassigned warning, like everything that's unassigned I want highlighted, so I get a reminder to look into that. You can obviously highlight overdue things. Like, you can do a lot of things with conditional formatting that you would also do in other applications like Excel. Now, everything I just showed you, if I copy the URL of this sheet and provide someone else in my team or somewhere else, some stakeholder with it, they would not see what I see here. They would see essentially something like more like this, like a plain sheet. And in order to enable them to see exactly what I see, we have so-called views. Views are here. So everything I just put together, I can store in a view. So if I say create view, I can store all these things. And column freezing is, by the way, something I forgot to show. So I can freeze a column, which is nice, like this. Anyway, going back to views, I will open this view now, which holds most of the configuration that I just put together earlier. So all of this is stored in here. You can see the structure that I apply to conditional formats, filtering and so on. So now if I share this sheet, I can do that here with this particular view. If I share this link, it will give the recipient the exact state of the sheet that I like them to see. What else? There's something we shipped more recently, which is history columns. I mentioned them earlier when I added a few columns, I think. Let's do that again. Let's add a column here, a history column, and let's take time between statuses. So now you will see there's a configuration necessary here. I can say, you know, I can say cycle time, for example. I want cycle time. So this is there's a from status and a to status, and I can say like the transition is to and to the transition to. So I say this would be in progress. We can do put multiple in here. I'm not sure which statuses are used here, so I will do that. And from in progress to, let's say, closed or done. I don't know, what is there, completed, resolved, sort of thing. And then, you know, this sort of cycle or this measurement obviously can trigger multiple times in the life cycle of an issue. And so this can occur multiple times, and you can tell which ones you would like to actually the measurement to entail here. So it could be the latest, could be the earliest, shortest, longest, an average, a median, all of them, or all including gaps. I'll leave it at the latest. And then I can define like the format of how this cell is meant to display this time. Let's make it in days. Save. Now I have a cycle time here. You know, the use cases and applications of these history columns are also endless. You can do cycle time, lead time, you can measure SLAs, although SLA columns are obviously all available as well natively. You can measure time with assignee and like identify bottlenecks where an individual or a team might need help, that sort of thing. So that's our history columns. In addition to that, just to wrap this up now, you can also, if really necessary still, if you want to put diagrams or charting on top of this, maybe in Excel or something, or Google Sheets, you can export the sheet. You can export this exact scope or data. Again, like you can export, you know, not just us, but also the smart and history columns that are not natively available in Jira. You can also, obviously in Jira, you can only export, I think, up to 1,000 issues. Here, like this, you can export 20,000 issues, and that's no problem. And you can choose the format and then, you know, go from there in whatever other application you might to visualize these things in. There's a full page mode. Quickly want to show you that because that's really nice, and that's also embeddable, and that helps you a bit focus on whatever you're up to with your work. And then last but not least, you know, here you can always contact us, give feedback, rate us. We have a proud all full 4-star rating on the Atlassian marketplace, and you can always suggest features and let us know what you need, and we actually respond to that and are very happy to implement things for customers all the time. That's, I think, the gist of it. Again, it's available for all Jira systems, deployment types, and project types. You can grab a free trial on the Atlassian marketplace. Just give it a test run, this, and you and your teams will love this and pick this up in no time. Thanks for attention. Hope this was a bit entertaining and good information. And yeah, get in touch if you have any further questions.